Welcome to Weld.com. Today I got Bob from franken-fab with me. We're going to build a backyard barbecue. And everything we're using is right here out of the shop. We're not going to buy anything except for the thermometer. And we even have our backyard Lincoln Electric Welder 140 that we're going to use that everybody has in their garage. So let's get started.
All right, so we got our compressor tank here. As Paul mentioned, we got a bunch of stuff, really just everything we found from our shop, from my shop, from around here in the lab. We are gonna show you everything in detail, how we're gonna cut everything, how we're gonna chop everything down. I'm gonna cut a little half moon on this side here for our firebox. And we got some pipe here we'll use for our exhaust. We got some 2x2 pipe we'll use for our square tubing we'll use for our legs. We might build a little rack out of some expanded metal. Paul's gonna show you what we're gonna do with our door here and our exhaust port, which we're gonna be doing some cutting with that. We're gonna be using a cutting wheel, right, to cut some of this?
Yeah, we're gonna use a cutting wheel and then the torch to make the radius cuts
work.
And you can see this is just the baseline where the door is gonna be, just so we can take our wire wheel and clean it up real good. And then we'll get started. Radius to corners, nice. Come around, radius to corners. So that'll be our door. Of course, we'll cut these brackets off, clean everything up real nice. And then our exhaust pipe will go right here. Our smoke pipe will go right almost in the center, because that's what you want. Bob was explaining to me that you want the smoke to come across and then go out the pipe. You don't want it to fill up. You don't want it to fill up the smoker and then come out the top. So Bob's got a pretty good recipe that's going to go along with this too. So we'll get started.
It's actually a David Dan barbecue's recipe. And he's the one that gave us some pointers on how to build our smoke box and how to have our smoke travel. So we're going to have an awesome recipe from them up here. And we're also going to have a detailed instructions on how we built this box. So hopefully you guys can build them at home.
So I got my flange wizard center finder here. Is what I'm gonna do is find exact center and I'll punch it and I'll hand it to Bob and he'll do the same on his side. And then what we'll do, we'll take a straight edge and make a straight mark for the top of the door cut. And then we'll move it down here to find the center on the side. Do the same thing we're doing here. We'll find the center, make a punch, hand it to Bob. He'll do his side. We'll take the straight edge, make a nice straight line for our door. And then we'll take the wraparound and connect the lines so they're nice and straight for the door. And then we'll get to cutting. But we got a little bit of rust, but we can clean it up and wire wheel it best we can and proceed with it.
Yeah, it's not too horrible. It's not the best looking lid. Thankfully, this will just be our lid. The whole base looks pretty good.
So we're gonna pick it up, put it on the table, and continue to lay out our holes. I'm gonna go ahead and find the center and make the penetration for the stack. So half of 14 and a half is of course 7 1/4. So I'll put my mark on it. And go from the side. Seven and a quarter. Seven and a quarter. Put my punch mark. There it is. So the OD of a 3-inch piece of pipe is 3.5 inches. So half of 3.5 inches is 1 3/4 inches. 1 3/4. 1 3/4. So I take the flange wizard, circle tracer, adjust it, and put the circle on it. So there we go.
This will be our firebox zone. So this is about halfway, and we're gonna make all this our smoke entryway. So our firebox will be here, and we'll be traveling all our smoke in, exit out the other side. We'll get it all cleaned up and we'll go from there.
Cool my face off.
Wow. So we're out here in this Florida 100 degree heat, cleaning on this barbecue grill that we're gonna be building. And man, these Fabri-Kool towels are
excellent,
great.
Excellent towels by Como. They make the best caps. They got these killer towels. Keep you 15 to 20 degrees cooler out here in this hot sun. Keep the sweat off your back and off your neck. Keep the sun off of you. We really dig them.
Good fit.
It's a pretty tight fit.
Oh yeah.
Little gap to fill.
So today we're gonna run the Bowler SG2 ER70S6 031 diameter with an AWS spec of A5.18.
I'm gonna have a couple little stitches on this thing. I'm gonna hit it right here and hit it right here, and then we're gonna turn it.
There you go.
And I'll double that one real quick.
I want to make sure I can get a square on it.
Yeah.
All right. What's that look like?
Good.
Okay, good. All right.
Was that you, Paul?
Yeah.
All right, so we got our tank cut out. We got our legs put on. We are right now mocking up the inside of the frame for our expanded metal to sit on. So we're gonna tack it up. We're gonna check everything. We're gonna check it out with our tacks on there just in case we gotta cut it, move it up, move it down. We wanna make sure we make an even smokehouse flow. All right, we're here with the lid. We got some 1 1/4 flat bar that we're gonna use as our smoke seal. We're just gonna stitch it up around here. We're gonna heat and bend some flat bar on these sides here. And then when we get it set up here on top of the lid, we should have a nice seal to keep all the smoke contained. And then we're gonna build some little homemade fancy hinges for right here. Not too fancy, something anybody can do. And then we're gonna move forward from there. So let's get the stitching this out. Check it out.
So I got the pipe set up in the saw. I'm gonna cut it on a 45 and we're gonna turn it around to make our stack so it goes straight up. So that'll be our stack piece. And that's exactly where it's gonna go on the stack. This end will go in the side and we'll weld it out and we'll cut it up here somewhere. So as you can see, Bob got the stack welded up and we're gonna install it at the end of the barbecue. And we're gonna tack it up and weld it.
We also got some nifty little homemade hinges that we got here. We used a little piece of rod and tubing, and I think this was a 5/16 rod.
5/16 rod with half inch tubing.
Outer diameter tubing.
And I just put it in the vise, bent them up, and we're gonna install them.
Be real slick.
Weld it out. Swinging.
Here, let's bring it all the way down. Have a lot of resistance.
No, it doesn't. But I mean, you don't want to have to reach.
No, we don't want. It doesn't need to go all the way back.
I was gonna say,
if it swings all the way good, that means we're lined up. Good.
Yep, something like right there would be perfect.
Yeah, we need to like.
Yep. Catch
All right, so we got our hinges fabbed and installed here and here. We donated a nice chipping hammer from the pile over there for our handle, and Paul's got us fashioned up. We're gonna use the rest of the chipping head for our lid stop. So we're gonna set it in here somewhere. We're gonna mark it up, tack it out, and then after we're done with this, we'll move on to the next step of putting on our exhaust pipe, our smoke stack, which we have ready to roll, and then we're gonna build our firebox.
But I wanted to move on to the next step, and it's kind of a bigger project. I'm gonna start cutting this firebox. So I'm gonna cut all the pieces up, prep them up, and then we'll start putting it together. All right, so I forgot to tell you guys to use a little guide to make your pieces nice and straight. So I just got me a little piece of extruded aluminum that I clamped down, as you can see, so I can get a nice straight line so we have a nice square box. So as you can see, I got the door laid out, and I wanted to lay out the door and use as much space as I could to make the door as big as I could so you can put decent sized logs in it so you don't have to really cut them up real, real small, even though they're gonna be kind of small anyway. But the door size I got is 13.5 wide by 14. So you should be able to get a good sized log in it. So I'm gonna put my hinges, after I cut this line, put my hinges on, and of course tack them, so when I cut the rest of the door out, it'll hold it right in place, and I don't have to try to tack the hinges and hold the door in place and all that, so it should fall right in place and open and close properly. So every barbecue needs a thermometer. So I got it all laid out on the lid. I'm gonna punch it and start drilling it. So as you can see, I added a few features to the barbecue smoker, the drains on the bottom, put the holes in it so the draft will come up through the smoker, And it got a swivel on the stack to control your heat.
Also added a couple of slick little spiderweb gussets, not really needed, but they sure look good.
So it was fun, you know, coming to franken-fab and delivering this barbecue smoker to Bob. Looks really good. Thanks for watching today. If you have questions or need help, go to our forum and connect with us, weld.com/forum.
And if you want to check out exclusive content and member perks, join our channel and support the weld.com community. We'll see you on the next one.